Talking about standard and equipment, so some information in my speech, of course, will be redundant, already mentioned, but I also have some additional information. Yeah, so before I want to go into details, on, since maybe not everybody of you knows who is Instrument Systems, so I would like to make a very brief introduction about Instrument Systems. So Instrument Systems is a German-based company, so we are founded in Germany in 1986, and our headquarters and all the production is happening in Munich. So we have around 100 people in Munich, and also we have now one location in Berlin with around 20 people, and these people there are focusing on goniometer systems, and they are experts for goniometer for automotive applications. So they make equipment for testing labs of car headlamp testing. So as you see, there was a big change end of last year that Konica Minolta, Japanese company that makes a lot of products, also measurement equipment for light measurements, for display measurement, has acquired the shares of Instrument Systems. So we are still Instrument Systems, but now we are owned by Konica Minolta in Japan. It's very good for us because now this strengthens our portfolio and also the possibilities on a global scale. So I think it's a very, very good match. As you can see, in most of the important markets, we have representatives that support us to develop the market. And the majority of our business is happening in Asia. So, yeah, more than 70% or 80% we make in Asia, because there is really production happening and we are very strong in production applications. So what we do is we make a spectroradiometer, which are necessary for the measurement of the light output. And then we also have camera-based solutions for display measurement. And then we have a lot of products around the spectroradiometer for different measurement tasks. So I will explain later also what kind of products there are. And we cover basically three main segments. So we are very strong in LED test and measurement. So all the big companies making quality LEDs, Osram, Philips Lumileds, Cree, and all the others use our equipment in their lab, but also in production. Because the production is very critical. We test every LED already on the wafer, the final product. And that way we need really very stable, very accurate instruments because we make binning and they sell it to their customers, so they have to make sure that whatever binning they make is really accurate. Second business is display test and measurement, so we have a lot of solutions for measuring displays. We started with automotive displays, dashboards and so on, and now we are also very successful in flat panel display testing. So computer screens, mobile phone screens, all that kind of things. Because also their highest accuracy is very important. And then of course we do a lot of solutions for all kind of other light sources like solid state lighting. So now we see LED moving from LED also now in solid state lighting in more applications. So we follow that chain of LED, and now we also of course offer a solution for measuring of LED in other products. Okay, so don't want to bore you with too much details. Now, yeah, let's start with the content. So what I want to emphasize, what I would like to explain, why we are now talking about spectroradiometer. So the conventional lighting industry, normally a lot of people did not care about spectroradiometer. They did use a photometer, and I will explain why this was okay, but why for LED this has changed. I also will show the standards for LED solid-state lighting, so of course there is the same information. Then talk about integrating spheres, goniometers, and make some conclusion. So let's start with photometer, colorimeter. So that was long time used in lighting industry, that customers are measuring like incandescent lamps, so it was very obvious how the spectrum would look like. So the spectrum was not in interest, only the output level was important. So that's why a photometer are perfectly fine. So photometer is silicon detector sensitive to light, and then because you want to measure like photometric quantities, you add some filter in front that matches the eye response of the human eye, because the interest is how does the human eye see that. So you put a filter on top, and then you adjust the make like some calibration, and then you can measure. So this was used a long time. What it cannot measure is spectrum and spectral data. So you're limited to one value, which gives you the total output. Okay, and this, if a beginning, customers have tried to use photometer also for measurement of LED, but there are some issues. As you can see on the right side, if you have there, one is the V lambda curve, which is the red one, and the yellow one, which you can see differentiates in the blue range, like 400 nanometer, and in the red range, there is some mismatch. So a filter cannot match perfectly the curve. There's always some mismatch. So it depends on the how many filter you use, so you can get better, but there will always be some mismatch. So with a photometer, you will not, if you want to measure LED, you will not get the proper results. There's always some mismatch, especially in the blue and red range. And if you have a white LED, there's a big peak in the blue, and then you have phosphor. So especially the big mismatch is in the blue range, so you will have also some significant mismatch in the results. That's why customers have now changed to using spectrometer for LED measurement, because of that reason. Yeah, there are a lot of different spectrometer. The good thing is with spectrometer, you can measure the spectral power distribution, so you really see how is the spectrum. Yeah, so you see down there a spectrum of a white LED, yeah, the blue peak, and then the second peak caused by the phosphor. And then the good thing is, once you have measured the spectrum, we can calculate everything by software. Yeah, we can calculate all photometric, retrometric value, color temperature, CRI. Everything can be computed from the spectrum.
Let me ask you one question.
Yes.
Because this is relevant to this slide. Mm-hmm. And it's a big issue in India right now. Mm-hmm. And I'm sure you're aware of the photobiological safety standard. Mm-hmm. And basically, you know, this UV light is converted into visible light also. There are remote phosphors and things like mm-hmm. that. This instrument of yours, mm-hmm. can it also measure whether the LED emitter source which somebody is using mm-hmm. was within the photobiological safety standards of IEC, or it has more UV than what is recommended to be a safe standard?
Mm-hmm. So we have solutions for that. The problem is there, if you want to measure like UVA, UVB, this is...
I think overall,
the different parts of the safety standard. Yeah, what you have to measure. The difficulty is for a broadband light source. This will cause stray light. So if you use an area spectrometer and you measure a broadband light source, you will have stray light. It will be difficult to measure that there is nothing, because you will measure a stray light. So we have some things we do with the compensation, but in the end you have to compensate the stray light, or you have to use what we have. We have a scanning system, like a double monochromator. I'm not in the presentation, because this is really for special cars. It's not for the broad target audience. So no, this
we
is
are
really
already building it into the Indian standard.
Yeah.
Because, you know, previously when it was totally unregulated, mm-hmm. nobody cared for these issues. Mm-hmm. And once these products started flowing to the market, mm-hmm. there are a lot of complaints. Mm-hmm. And now our officials have woken up to this mm-hmm. reality.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So for this you need a special equipment that really is able to measure and that UV to prove that there is nothing. So normally for LED, there should be nothing, but...
A lot of publicity is there in the press regarding the safety hazard.
Yeah. Yeah, but I think for normal LED, this is probably not a very big issue. I think there are more other issues. Okay, this is always...
Yeah, in science, they need a proof.
If you have to prove that there is nothing, it's very, very difficult. You need good instruments to prove that there is nothing. Because otherwise you measure something and then you're not sure, is it radiation or is it stray light? Okay, so this is, we have everything in software, high accuracy, so we really can measure all the information that customers are looking for LEDs and LED-based luminaires. Okay, so yeah, what is typically used is an array structure radiometer, as was also shown before. So the benefit there is measurement time is very fast. Yeah, so the whole spectrum is measured in one shot. There's one detector with the amount of pixel, and every pixel measures a portion of the light. So the light is split, and then each detector pixel measures a portion of the light. So this is very, very fast. And there, of course, are big differences in the kind of design of the instruments. There are low-end systems, high-end systems. Of course, there it depends on how is the optical design, what is the quality of the detector, how is everything made together. And this is really what differentiates us and makes us very successful, that we have, for challenging tasks, we have the high-accuracy instrument that are required. So one is the accuracy, also stability over time. That is not good if it's changing, and then you cannot trust the results. Okay, so spectrometer is what is needed. And then, of course, what is different than a photometer is the calibration procedure. Yeah, photometer, you measure some electric value, and then you make some file to say what electric value corresponds to what measurement value. With the spectrometer, this is more difficult, because each pixel corresponds to some wavelength. So first you have to assign which pixel is assigned to which wavelength, and then you have to also make a calibration for each pixel to say what is the value the pixel is measuring and what's the value it should be. So you make a correction file for each pixel. And this is really our strong point. We have the very good instruments, and we also have a very good calibration procedure to give that high accuracy. And there's also the very big step for our company. We are have ISO 17025. We are ISO 17025 accredited testing lab. So we are recognized nationally that we can give official testing reports. And for a lot of customers, especially automotive, this is very important that they get an instrument and also they get some paper that proves the accuracy. Yeah. So, and ILAC is the international organization that takes care of that to make accreditation for international testing labs. Okay, so now I would like to come, as we have seen before, there's different standards for different products. Yeah, for LED, low power, high power, solid state lighting products, luminaires. And on the next slide, we see that there are some standards measuring single LEDs, which is CIE 127, but this is more for low power LEDs. There are some things in preparation for high power LEDs. And the one that's very interesting for people making luminaires is LM79, because this defines the methods how to test solid state lighting products. Yeah, there are, as mentioned before, some safety standards. Photobiological safety was mentioned. There are different standards taking care of different aspects. Okay, so luminaires, there are a lot of different shapes and sizes. So there's a lot of solutions. Okay, so what is LM79? Because this is very important standard. What does it take care of? It's talking about the proof methods for the electrical and photometric measurement of solid-state lighting products. So it's tailored for solid-state lighting products, and it talks about how to measure electrical quantities and also photometric quantity. And then also, yeah, some this is for illumination purposes, so there are some limitations to say what is the standard targeted for. And basically what the standard says, there are two ways to measure photometric quantities. One is integrating sphere, the other one is the goniometer. So both can be used. There are some requirements in how the sphere should look like, how the goniometer should look like. So don't want to go into details now, but this is the two options. And there we can see the two ways. Yeah? Either we use a sphere, we connect the light in all directions, we measure that, and we know what's the total output. If we want to know how is emission at different angles, then we need to use a goniometer. Yeah, so we check distribution at different angles, and then we have the distribution characteristics. Also, we can measure luminous flux with the goniometer, but of course, this takes more time. Yeah. There are different ways to test. You can test inside inequalities here, you can test at the sideboard. For LED-based luminaires, only forward emission, it's also possible to use sideboard of inequalities here. Conventional light sources have to put inside if there's emission in all directions. So one important thing was mentioned before. So what we do is we have an integrating sphere, we use some calibration lamp, we make a calibration of the system. But now if customer wants to make a measurement, that setup is different. So the customer is changing the sphere setup. There is some process to compensate for that. This is very important. If that's not done well, also the results deviate. So it's a very important process. If the calibrated setup is changed to another setup, then this has to be also, there's been some spectral correction for the difference. And there's a process to do that. Don't want to go into detail, but basically what you do, you make a reference measurement with the lamp at the original setup, then on the working setup, and then it's possible to make a compensation between the two. Yeah, and there's integrating spheres available at different sizes, yeah, from small ones to big ones. It always depends what is the size of the luminaire that needs to be tested. Yeah, so different sizes we also offer. Yeah, and then of course you have things you can measure inside, sample stage, outside, also with temperature control, there are different possibilities. There was the introduction about the mirror type goniometer. So there are different goniometer types for solid state lighting. So one is the mirror type that was shown earlier. So there the mirror moves around, which is good. It's a good solution. But typically these systems are quite large, typically quite expensive, and you need typically a big room because it has to rotate. So typically, room requirements are very, very, very tough. And also the mirror, it's always the question, if the mirror is changing, then also the results can change. So mirror can also be an issue there. So that's why Instrument System has introduced a different goniometer design that is specially developed for LED-based luminaires. So we put the luminaire on the goniometer and we turn the luminaire. So detector is on the other side, and we turn the luminaire, and then we look at different angles. But of course, this is only working for LED-based luminaires that have only forward emission, and only for devices that are not location dependent. There are some lamps, if you move them, like incandescent lamps, the output will change. So then it's not possible to move them. So our goniometer is really tailor-made for LED-based luminaires. Yeah, and one thing I want to mention, it's obvious the burning position in our test setup is always like this. Yeah, so this is one potential drawback that if somebody wants to test the sample like this, this is not possible by design. So sample is always like that.
For the streetlight application,
this is a limitation for streetlight application. The output of the LED will not matter. Yeah, if I put the LED like this, or like this, it will not matter. What matters is heat. So if you have a design, if you put, this is optimized that the heat goes away like this, and now if you put like this, then heat will be different, output will be different. So the LED is not the critical, but the heat is the critical factor. Yeah. In that case, customer would need to monitor temperature and really make sure that under both conditions he gets the same temperature, then he will get the same results. So typically we tested that intensively, and for normal lights, like down lights, this is working fine. Of course, for street lamps, it really depends on the design, if that's can be tested in this condition. Yeah, so there are different solutions we have. We have for medium-sized down lights, and also we have a big one, can be used also for larger luminaires. Okay, so this is the smaller one, how this would look like. Yeah, we have this either a photometer or the spectral radiometer on one side, and then on the other side we have the sample, and we move that, and then we scan half the sphere, how is the emission pattern on that different angles. And the nice thing is, these are some results for different luminaire types. So you see by design, some are very have a narrow emission, some have a wide angle emission. This really depends on what kind of LEDs are used, what how's the optical design, so it will give a different output. And then what we can use, if we use a spectral radiometer, we can also measure the spectral characteristics at different angle. So if the customer wants to check, do I, under different conditions, still get the same, like the color temperature, then you can also use that. Yeah, then there's one example where we've seen that the color temperature is changing at different angles. So the manufacturer can check, is that intended, or maybe he has improved the optical design. So this can also be some very helpful information. Okay, so I would like to come to my conclusion. So first of all, for LED measurement and solid-state lighting measurement, it's advisable to use a spectrometer to get accurate results. Then there are two options using integrating spheres. Their design is very critical, and also the procedures. So if you have an integrating sphere, if you make improper procedures, results will not be good. So it's really, you also have to understand the handling and procedures, how to do that. And as I mentioned, the self-absorption correction is very important that you follow that. And also from time to time, there has to be some recalibration, because also the sphere is aging, so this has to be also taken into consideration. The coating, everything. And then, we proposed the concept of the turning luminaire goniometer that is well suited for solid state lighting. And the benefits are there really. It's more compact and also less expensive than a big mirror goniometer. So especially for smaller samples, we think this is a very, very good alternative. So thanks for your attention.
Thank you.